Thailand is red-lighted in the UK for quarantine purposes alongside Brazil, China and the US. Travelers from Thailand must quarantine for 14 days when entering the UK. Clarification late on Friday night is disappointing news for Thai authorities as the kingdom, earlier in the week, was green-lighted by the European Union. The decision appears to have taken no account of Thailand's exemplary performance in fighting the COVID-19 threat at such a heavy cost to the public and the economy, which has been left devastated. Contrary to earlier authoritative reports, it emerged on Friday night that the United Kingdom has red-lighted passengers from Thailand when it comes to an exemption from quarantine on entering the country from July 10 under the UK's new traffic lights quarantine system. The decision places Thailand, like much of Asia including China and the United States, in the same boat when it comes to the assessment of risk under the British government's scheme. There has been a certain amount of confusion and consternation in Bangkok when it became clear late on Friday night that the United Kingdom had failed to give the green light to Thai travellers visiting Britain as part of the UK government's new approach to health controls in respect of the COVID-19 virus as that country throws open its borders to trade and travel. Instead, Thailand has been given the red light, placing it on the lowest tier of countries along with China, the United States and Brazil. Authoritative reports, only hours before, suggested Thailand would be green-lighted with no quarantine. Earlier authoritative press reports, including such sources as the Financial Times, had expressly suggested that Thailand was on the list to be green-lighted. In addition, during the week, the European Union listed Thailand as one of only 15 countries from which passengers would not be required to quarantine and could travel freely within its borders, including the Schengen area, with the appropriate visa. UK scrapped travel bridge and tourist bubble concepts in June in favour of a simpler system. Weeks ago, it was announced that the UK was doing away with concepts such as travel bubbles and air bridges, replacing them with a simple traffic light system. The UK has also maintained flight links to most countries, at this time, including Thailand, allowing its nationals to fly home through a limited number of commercial flights. It placed a ban on non-essential outgoing flights, which is now due to be lifted. Under this new regime, a green light for any country means that passengers are not subject to any quarantine requirement. Among these countries are New Zealand, Australia, and Taiwan. Amber means that there has been a deal or arrangement brokered between the two countries to facilitate travel and ongoing economic interests while limiting the health threat. Passengers from countries with red status are required to quarantine for 14 days. Among those countries placed in the amber category have been some European nations hardest hit by the virus, including Italy, Spain, and France. Very few Asian countries have not been given the red light from Whitehall except for Taiwan, South Korea, Vietnam, and Hong Kong. On Saturday, one analyst pointed out that very few Asian countries are on the green list. The four notable exceptions are Hong Kong, South Korea, Taiwan, and Thailand's growing rival for both tourism and trade, Vietnam. The traffic light system is part of the UK's strategy to reopen the country to trade and tourism as it faces one of the sharpest economic fall-offs in the long mercantile history of the country. The system is being implemented by Whitehall civil servants as Britain attempts to reopen its vital trading links and commercial interests. It was announced by Transport Secretary Grant Shapps in June and comes into effect on July 10. UK plans already embroiled in controversy with Leicester lockdown and Greece halting flights. It has already been hit with controversy in the UK, where a second wave has broken out even as the British public go about taking summer holidays. Many people are desperate to travel and holiday on sunnier shores. An outbreak in the city of Leicester has seen that city and the area surrounding it, in the heart of England, shut down again. Even as the traffic light system was announced, Greece, a green-lighted country, announced that it was halting all inbound flights from the UK for several weeks as the European nation is adamant to protect its strategically vital tourism industry, which it is carefully nursing back to life. The Greek government has reopened the country after the pandemic swept through Europe with careful and practical measures. It still considers that the disease poses a threat both to its population and its lucrative tourism trade. Observers trying to understand the UK's decision. In Thailand, observers are trying to understand why the kingdom, with one of the most impressive performances in fighting the virus, in a similar range to New Zealand and even Taiwan, has been relegated to being a red-lighted country. One explanation is that UK authorities are not sure of the threat posed by Thailand along with nearly every other country in Asia due to the proximity to China. Thailand has only seen 58 deaths from COVID-19 and has taken decisive and costly steps to prevent the outbreak in the kingdom. The country is now well past the 28-day incubation period for the disease, with the last case of local transmission seen on May 25, 40 days ago. UK quarantine is self-enforced with monitoring. The brighter news is that under the UK's quarantine scheme, travellers are not taken into state quarantine or expected to pay large sums of money to stay in a government-approved hotel. They are subject, however, to monitoring at their place of stay. Reports from the UK suggest that the organisation of the scheme, at this point, is somewhat shambolic, as police have not yet been briefed on what action to take against those who violate the new quarantine orders, which will be effective only 6 days from now. Further reading. Move to prevent a tourism wipeout as minister pushes three-phase plan especially targeting China. IATA calls on countries like Thailand to think again over quarantine schemes and travel curbs costing jobs. Only 2,000 foreigners have yet registered to be reunited with loved ones as tourism to also reopen. Key ministries met on Sunday to discuss access by foreigners to the kingdom and a tourism relaunch. Thai public says no to foreign tourism and also predicts 1 to 2 years for travel to return to normal. Only hope for foreigners locked out of Thailand is easing continues with strict controls on entry. Ministers suggest an easing of the travel ban for some tourists but a continued state of emergency. Thailand plans to prioritize Asian countries in its search for safe COVID-19 tourism bubble partners. Australian envoy says its embassy and others continue to work on helping stranded foreigners get home. Access to Thailand opening up. It will be cautious, quite expensive with tight regulation and ministry controls. Thai security chief suggests a full reopening of the kingdom to international flights from July 1. New normal for foreigners seeking access to Thailand even after flights resume if virus persists as a factor. Growing concern and frustration among a large number of expats cut off from their families in Thailand. Australian man's heartbreak cut off from his Thai wife, begs to be included on repatriation flights. Thailand extends ban on inbound flights until July 1 at the earliest. Blow to foreigners and tourism. Spouses of Thai wives down under denied access to limited repatriation flights from Australia this week. Australian retiree is spending his own pension money on supporting the poor during the crisis in Chiang Mai. Stranded 66-year-old German tourist seeks help on the street from a Good Samaritan in central Bangkok. Police in Phuket await post-mortem results after deaths of two elderly Westerners last weekend at home. Stranded Russians offered free food in Phuket as Aeroflot begins to airlift over 21,000 stranded home to safety. Thai expats stranded overseas due to COVID-19 travel restrictions. Farangs stranded abroad due to lockdown in Thailand.